Hey, what's up, guys? I'm here in Photoshop and I've discovered some new features in Photoshop CC that I've been waiting for a long time, and I always wondered why they didn't have these. The first is brush smoothing, so we'll see the new section up here when you're using either the brush, pencil, or eraser. And so you can see when you're drawing a stroke by hand, you know, you might get some wobbles in there and it's not that great. But let's undo that, and we can turn on smoothing. You can slide it all the way up to 100%. And as you're drawing, you can see there's a little pink line that follows behind your brush, and the paint comes from that line, and it just makes things much smoother, especially if you're using a mouse. So I'm using the mouse now, and I can make even smooth curves with the mouse. Well, not perfect, but a lot easier than without them smoothing. So see, here's with the mouse with no smoothing turned on. And we've got a few options for that. Let's turn that back on 100%. And you can drop down and use the slider if you want, but I just like dragging on the text. But we've got a few options. So that was adjust for zoom, which we'll get into later. So this is the pulled string mode. And it's a little confusing at first, but you know what it's doing is you have this pink circle around the outside, and the pink string is there like before. But it won't actually start drawing until you get outside that circle, which means that you can use it with smoothing, but then you can also have these sharp corners. So that could be really useful for making a nice, perfect shape. Let's undo that. And let's look at the next one. Turn that off. And stroke catch up. So you can see as you go faster, the string gets longer. And when you get slow, it gets really close to the brush, which means you can get some like intricate details in there, but then have a nice long strokes with a curve. Okay, let's look at the next one. And this is catch up to stroke end, which is a little bit hard to show with a pen because when you let go, it makes that weird little thing. But if you're using it with a mouse, you can drag, and as soon as you let go, it shoots to the end. Not really sure how that would be useful, but yeah, maybe you'll find some uses for it. Let's undo those. And let's adjust for zoom. So how this one works is you have your regular smoothing. But then if you zoom out, you'll get more smoothing when you're zoomed out. So when it's really small, because then you'll need that extra bit to help you out. And of course, if you turn them all off, you just get regular smoothing, and it's very nice. It works a little bit like the stroke catch-up, but not quite as extreme. And of course, you can use pressure with these as well, so you can get thinner and thicker as you curve around. And that's it for the smoothing. It just seems really useful, and I always wondered why they don't have that. Now the next one is symmetry, another one I always wondered why. I've seen in other programs, but Photoshop didn't have it. The trick with symmetry is that you actually have to enable it. It's not on by default. So we have to go into Edit and Preferences and Technology Previews. And once that opens, you'll find it down here, Enable Paint Symmetry. And once it's enabled, you'll see this little butterfly button. And we have a whole bunch of different options there. So let's turn on new vertical. And you can actually rotate that and choose how you want it to go. And then once you press enter, or I guess double click, you can start drawing with symmetry. And of course that also works with the smoothing. So let's check out one of the other options. We have new horizontal, which is basically the same thing. Dual axis, this is where things get a little more interesting. And of course, along with rotating, with this one, you can also resize it. Now this could be really interesting for some intricate, you know, work, like some Celtic knot work, or suppose you were making some interesting fabric designs or something. This is already starting to look interesting, and I've barely even done anything. Let's check out another one. Let's go back. New diagonal again. This is basically the same as the first two. I mean, you could basically make this with the first two just by rotating it. New wavy, and let's make that a little wider so it's easier to demonstrate. And so, yeah, it's a little bit weird. Like, as you get further away from the line, it starts to get a little messed up. But when you're up close to the edge there, it's okay. Little bit weird, but again, these are technology previews, so it's not really a finished product. Again, we have new circle. It's kind of the same thing. You know, when you're real close to the edge, it works all right, but as you get further out, it starts to get a little messed up. So up close, it's all right. Then out here, it's a little weird. Okay, and yeah, the rest are pretty much the same. New spiral. Oops. Yeah. Yeah, it's getting weird. Okay, and finally, we have new parallel lines. This one, not quite sure what's going on with this one. I guess you just have two lines? Yeah, I guess so. Not really sure how you would use that, but hey, it's a tool and you can find a use for any tool, I guess. So that is it. That is the new exciting tools for Photoshop. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe, like this video, share it with your friends, all that good stuff. See you next time.